Convention, but the Fourth Geneva Convention and the Hague Regulations are clear: the local population are normally called protected persons. They're protected persons because they're protected from violations which the Fourth Geneva Convention has said should be committed against them. And anything that has to benefit the local population must benefit solely the local population, not people brought in illegally, as international law says. And it's quite clear that these services do not benefit the local population in that meaning, in the term that's required under international law. They may benefit some local illegal population, but that's not what the test should be. And very few Palestinians have been using the services. Even if they had been doing it, it wouldn't be a good enough argument, because the purpose of the tram line is to integrate settlements with the Green Line, with the population on the other side. But even if it were a good argument that some more local Palestinians were benefiting in a greater way, that wouldn't be a good argument. But actually, it's not even true that they are. Again, some Palestinian communities clearly benefit from the Togland landfill site. There's no denial about that. But the fact is, it largely benefits these illegal settlements. And while these illegal settlements are there and are benefiting from the landfill site, they're assisting Israel in these violations of international law. So I think the evidence is plentiful, and I don't really understand. And the directive is absolutely clear. It leaves it to each local country, each country within the EU, to decide what is sufficient evidence for its purposes. And as Veolia doesn't really deny any of this, as I've said, the UN has been clear. They've said it's clearly a violation. I read from that UN resolution. Now, I mean, the Israelis and lots of countries like the Sri Lankans are very unhappy with the UN Human Rights Council. And more countries should be more unhappy with the UN Human Rights Council. But they're either legally right or they're legally wrong. And I think it's very problematic. This is very expensive litigation that Veolia could map. And obviously there are very significant companies with much more resources than most local authorities. But, you know, if they're prepared to stand up to other bodies where they think they're making a legal decision, they should be equally prepared to stand up to a big bully like Veolia. But I understand their fears, because they don't want to use council taxpayers' money on a bad legal case. But I repeat, I don't think it is a bad case. So local authorities who have the courage of their own conviction should proceed. And I genuinely think it's not straightforward as to whether Veolia would actually take it to court. They really have to assess it very carefully. And a local authority that goes through this the right way, makes clever decisions in an appropriate way, I mean, ask Veolia to answer all the questions and still exercise their discretion. I'm not sure. I mean, judges normally are not very happy to interfere with decisions made under discretionary powers unless they're what's called irrational. You know, the test is lawfulness and irrationality and lawful process. So as long as the process has been fair for the decision, as long as it's not irrational, which means totally mad, that is what the irrationality test is. It's totally mad. No sane local authority applying the same, looking at the same evidence could with in all sanity reach the same conclusion. That's effectively what's called a Wensbury test under the case. And then it has to be, they have to have got the law right as to what they're assessing. So if they hit each of those nails on the head, then they should be able to do it. And I think they should be presenting Evershed, or whoever their legal advisors are externally, with a positive argument and seeing whether or not it meets the test of working within their discretionary power. I doubt they're doing it that way round, I'm afraid. If you ask the lawyer the right questions in the right way, they should be able to